Hello guys, welcome back to Playing the Dragon Boy, and come on, really? No, don't, stop. There we go, okay. Now I'd like to get back to the... Okay, there we go. Anyways, welcome back to Playing the Dragon Boy, and today I'm doing a mod review on the Primitive Mobs mod. Get out of here, you're not supposed to be here. So let's put these this armor on, because I'm sure we're going to need it. So let's just grab a bunch of spawn eggs, and we'll get started with the review. So, I'm going to go down into this, whatever the heck this was. I don't remember. It's some failed thing I was trying to make. You know what? How about you die, Skelly? Thank you. And you should go down too, pig. Seriously? You went up? I have Flansmon set up, so I may or may not die at some point. Okay. So let's start up with the first mob, which is the Traveling Merchant. He's kind of just like a villager. You know, he's not too different from a villager. I don't think he drops anything, but yeah, just a villager, I guess. Now, Haunted Tool is a flying tool that, okay, first of all, I don't know if it deals the amount of damage that... Ooh. Okay, it does do a little bit of damage. But... as you can see, if you just spawn all these around, you get a bunch of random tools every time. And the cool thing about it is if you end up getting, like, a diamond tool like this, and you kill it, you get that tool with full health on it. Now, that all depends on if you can ever find one, because I'm not actually too sure where some of these things show up. Some of them are kind of self-explanatory, like, you know, there's a water creature, it's going to show up in the water, but, you know... things like that. Okay, I'm going to set home real quick, if I can remember how to do that. So is it like spawn set? Ah, whatever, I'll figure it out later. Just hopefully I don't die again. So let's go up here so that we don't die, and we'll set down this mimic. Now, I think it works where if you open it, okay, so there's a tool in it. Yeah, how about you stop hitting me? And then it does actually open. Now, I wonder... oh, there we go. That's what I was looking for. So that's a normal mimic. That's what a normal mimic is like. There are other mimics that just kind of turn into something else. Like, see how that turned into a zombie? Or... oh, I think I spawned another one inside of that. And it's the same thing. Okay. But that's basically what the mimic is, and I'll show you the rest of what it can do later. So now we have a support creeper, which slows you down once it gets near enough to you, and then blows up. So it's kind of just to help other creepers or other mobs in general to attack you. Now we have here the treasure slime. So yeah, this is a slime, and when you kill it, it has treasure in it. Now let's see if I can get a bigger... there we go. We'll just spawn in a bunch of these. So that one had redstone in it. That one had ender pearl, as you can see. It looks like that one has a saddle in it, maybe. That one has a heart in it. So I think that just, you know, explodes hearts and maybe it heals you. Yep, that one had a saddle in it. That had lapis in it. That had, you know, a bunch of different things and snowballs and so forth. So... ooh, cake. That's good. Everyone loves cake. Okay. So, yeah, that's what the treasure slime does. It has some treasure in it that it's kind of nice to get when, you know, you're just wandering around. And if you see one of these, maybe you can get an ender pearl or a saddle right off the bat. Now, here, wait. Let's kill all these guys. And we don't need these. We can set this cake down and eat it, and then take these cookies. Now, the next one is Festive Creeper. So, it looks nice enough, but then it throws a piece of TNT at you, like, booyah, I was tricking you, and then you die. So, yep, that's the Festive Creeper. Now, let's just get a closer look at it without it attacking us. It's not all that friendly, but you can kill them and get the achievement Uninvited Guest, because that's kind of what it is, an uninvited guest. Now, let's fly back over. And the next one is the Rocket Creeper. Now, this one, you know, really, when you look at it, kind of sounds pretty dangerous. So, let's go ahead and see what this guy's gonna do. Maybe he'll, you know, he'll be like, I'm a bazooka, and shoot bazookas at us. Or, he'll just be a derp. Oh, goodness. Oh, so you just fly up into the air. Okay, so let's see. Let's try that again. If I just go... So they fly up into the air and slam down on you. And I guess the only advantage to having that is that it will be able to avoid getting hit by you. Now, what happens if you... Well, I guess... Here, wait. I want to see what happens if you put it under a tree. Well, automatically explodes. And it deals no damage. Oh, no. It deals damage. And let's just get rid of all of these items that we've already used and we don't need. Okay, and then let's put down a bunch of other things. There we go. And now, the next one we're going to use is a brain slime. Now, that sounds pretty disgusting. If already slimes aren't disgusting, like, if you listen to the sound they make when they're jumping around, like, does that sound anywhere near pleasant? No, not really. Unless, I don't know, maybe you love slime? Maybe you do, I don't know. But, here you go. So that is the... Let me see if I can get some bigger ones. So it looks like they'll get on top of your head, and that's probably how they deal damage to you. It doesn't look like they can get that big, though. Okay, so let's go into... So yes, they go onto your head, and then they just kind of stick there, and you gotta take them off and kill them, or else, you know, you'll lose health. And then there's pink slime balls. I'm not sure if those really do anything. Now, it's really easy to kind of kill these guys if you know they're there, because they'll just jump onto your head and you can just smack them off before they even really get to do anything, like this. Now, I think they can do normal damage to you, like just coming up and hitting you. But they are kind of annoying, especially with that sound they keep making. And the fact that they're able to follow you, like, crazy. Okay, let's get away from these guys. They don't need to be here anymore. Come on, leave me alone. You still want to follow me? Oh, well, that's too bad. You're dead now. So let's spawn. Okay, Snow Golem. I don't know why you're in here. How did you do that? You shouldn't be here. Mother Spider. So, oh, goodness, I wasn't prepared for that. We have the mother spider here, which has, obviously, her little baby spiders, her little babby spiders, and herself. It makes a lovely sound when you hit it. Now, I'm not sure why, but I can't get them to do the thing. Sometimes they'll spawn with, There you go. See, sometimes they'll spawn with the babies on their head. Now, then, it appears only when they have the babies on their head, do you get a spider egg, which you can right-click on the ground and get a little, spider friend. That follows you around, and if you want to pick it back up again, you do that. And I think maybe it attacks for you. I don't know. It doesn't look like that's what it's doing. Now, let's wait. If I put, like... Okay, so the next one here is the Sheep Man. And he's just a Sheep Man that trades with you. And I think these guys appear in the Nether. Now, if I take this guy out, and I attack this guy, then you do nothing. Okay, you're a jerk, and I'm gonna throw you away. So these guys don't drop anything. Now, we have a Blazing Juggernaut, which is, I'm assuming, a very powerful version of... Whoops, I don't want to spawn Sheepman. Why does he have a baby villager? That's not how it's supposed to work, Sheepman. Just toggle downfall, because that's annoying. And it's killing our juggernauts. Now, as you can see, he seems to just be following us around. I'm not sure if he actually wants to kill us. Yes, he does. Okay, so he follows you around and hurts you. That seems to be about all he does. Now, we have a summoner. If we spawn a summoner, they summon little heads, which is interesting. That I'm assuming are trying to attack you. Now, does he do anything after that? Yes, yes, he spawns more heads and makes you drop things, which is actually a pretty cool ability. Now, I'm gonna kill you. Ooh, okay, so they drop skull minion orbs, which allow you to spawn your own little minions, which will follow you around and help you. So if I did this, we'd have a ton of minions. So it looks like they have skeletons, they have yellow skeletons, and they have wither skeletons, which all probably have their own special little effects. Okay, yep. But it looks like they're kind of kamikaze things, because as soon as they hit something, they die immediately. Or maybe that's just because it was a zombie. Now, you can just kill these guys if they're getting annoying. Okay, next one. So we've summoned Bewitched Tome. So that is a book. It doesn't want to do any damage. Hey. Jerk. Okay. We'll spawn this Bewitched Tome again so we can see what it... Oh, there he is. Okay, revenge! This is just a wither with some... or another wither. A skeleton with some of the Flan's mod armor on. But... So yeah, they will deal damage to you, but when you kill them, you get an enchanted book, which is nice. So if we just do this, let's see, how many different types of enchanted books will they drop? They don't deal too much damage, but if you get teamed up on them, by them... Ooh, Silk Touch, that's good. Silk Touch again, Feather Falling, and a couple over here, Unbreaking, and Infinity One, which is nice. Now, apparently when you throw the books on the ground, they disappear. Unless they're still there? No. Okay. So, that's all for that row that I have. I guess they're just going to disappear. And for the next thing we have here, let me just go back over. And... slash time... Okay, let's head back over to the little platform area where we're going to fight all the mobs, and we'll spawn in some new guys. So the first thing we're going to have is the Skeleton Warrior, which, well, I imagine be like kind of like a buffed up zombie, maybe, kind of thing. Ooh, what are those? Oh, that's the cake. And there's those little mobs down there, those little slimes, brain slimes. Okay. And game mode, yes. Okay, so yes, it looks like they have a combination of a sword. And, oh, this is what attacked me. Oh, my goodness. Jeez, they deal a lot of damage. That's what attacked me earlier. Oh, I didn't mean to spawn the summer. Didn't I already do this one anyways? Here, let's remove these from my inventory. Okay, the Skeleton Warrior is actually... pretty dangerous. So it goes from ranged to melee, and it does a ton of damage with its iron sword. So that's pretty interesting. Now we have here the chameleon. You gonna... Yep. So it just changes to the color of the surrounding, and this is just a little peaceful mob, which is kind of cool to have around in your house. So if we put it, like if we put a chameleon, let's say, here and here, we'll see the difference in the skin coloring of it, hopefully. So that one looks like it's finished, and this one is slowly getting there. So now they're finished, and see, it looks different. Now, if you put it on something kind of multicolored, like this, what would they do? It might turn into the color of the wood. It looks like that's what it's doing. It's turning into the middle part. Okay, that's interesting. And then as it's walking, it automatically adjusts, which is cool. Now, if we put it in water, will it adapt to the block below it, or will it adapt to the water? It looks like it wants to adapt to the water. And they're not too great at swimming, are they? They're a little derpy when it comes to that. So this is pretty interesting mob, actually, because... I mean, look at that. That's pretty skilled, if I do say so myself. So let's just put this guy down here for the last one. And see in a second what he turns into. Now this is, since we're here by the water, this is a lily lurker. Now you can stand on top of these until they recognize you're there and start moving. They may not even start moving unless, you know, you get in the water. But what these do is, you know, they look like lily pads. So you're like, oh, lily pads. But as soon as you get in the water, well, usually, hello? Okay, there we go. They registered now. As soon as you get in the water, they start to attack you. Now, this one seems a little glitchy, this mob. Oh, okay, there we go. So, yes, this is a lily lurker. Maybe they're just stationary for a little while? Okay, let's not die. Oh, I died anyways. There's a summoner skull. So let's put down, I think, no, that's the wrong thing. Sheepman, Smith, and Lost Miner. And that should be it. So that's the Lost Miner. He seems to be following us around, probably because he wants to escape. Did he just give us emeralds for no reason? Is this what he does? Like, if you find them, they give you emeralds or stuff like that? Huh, interesting. Now, these guys, I guess that's just the thing. If you find them in the mines, then you'll be glad to treat yourself to a few emeralds that they'll probably give to you. And the last thing I think we have on this is the Sheepman Smith, who walks around in the... He's also in the Nether, I believe. And if you kill him, doesn't appear to do anything. He seems to be wanting to go somewhere, but he can't do it for some reason. And if you hit the anvil, it actually kills him. Okay. And there is actually something else, so let's go game mode. Oh, that's not how you do that. Mode C. And let's head over really quickly to our normal spot. And get rid of these. Because there are a few things left in a chest that I have yet to show you guys. And that is over. That was inventory pets. Where is it? There they are. Okay. And that's over here. Now let's open this up. And you've got... These are the different mimic things that the mimic can turn into. So you've got Haunted Tool, which we saw. Zombie, which we saw. An Ender Mimic, which is an Ender... if you find an Ender Chest around, it may be an Ender Mimic. An Explosion Mimic, which... explodes when you, wait a second, let me kill these. Which explodes when you open it. Bat Mimic, which just gives you a bunch of bats. Not really that scary at all. And that's it for the mimics. So let's, oh wait, we have two more. Okay, Evil Mimic, which is just a mimic. And then probably the one that'd be the most dangerous, the Skeletal Warrior Mimic, because these things are very, very dangerous, as we've accidentally seen so far. So let's get rid of these. Just put these back. Now let's grab these. These are the skulls that you can get from the summoners. So we have Wither Skull, which gives Wither effect. Yellow Skull, which... probably does paralysis is what I'm thinking is going on there. Magenta Skull. Here, wait, let's go into game mode, okay, let's not do that. Yeah, let's kill these guys because they're attacking us. Blue Skull, which will do stuff. I can't tell anymore. I'm sure that does something interesting, like set him on fire. Okay, so we have the pet treasure slime spawner. Get away from me. Which is a pet slime, and they seem to multiply. So these guys are happier, or something. Game. Okay, so these guys are not mad with you. These are nice little slimes. So don't kill them. And then the precious pickaxe haunted tool spawner, which has an interesting looking pick. It looks like a wooden pick, but it's not. So if we just take this out. Now, what does this precious pick do? It's very quick! Now, if we go into game mode. Okay, so let's get some ores and see what it can mine. So let's get the basic ores that we'd be worried about getting. So it needs to be able to mine this and this and this. So we're gonna start. Obviously, it should be able to mine coal. Get out of my way. I'm sorry. I hope. And I messed it with the screen. Here. Oh, now I can't respawn, and we're having issues. And we're back. You're gonna have to deal with these red dots. I had that fixed before, but since I died, it's not fixed now. So we're gonna see. Iron. Obviously, it can mine that. Gold. It can mine this. And diamonds. It can mine. And how much durability does it have? If I do F3H, and it does have quite a bit of durability. Now let's see. Let's see. Game mode. Let's see, and let's get a diamond pick out to compare the amounts of health that each one of these has. Okay, so it has the same amount of health as a diamond pickaxe. So it's basically a diamond pickaxe. But, you know, it'd be a nice find. Anyways, guys, that's going to conclude this mod review. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and a comment. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Don't forget to have a good day or a night or whatever time of the day it is that you're watching this. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.